10. Today we are going to revise the poem Tiger in the Zoo. Okay, so Tiger in the Zoo, what does the poem depict? First of all, in your words, let me tell. Yes, Daksh, you again have gone there. Yes, what does Tiger in the Zoo depict? What this poem actually wants to deliver? It delivers freedom is important, right? Sit down. Okay, so this poem, it is delivering the helplessness of a caged tiger. When the tiger is in the cage, he is feeling helpless, he is feeling sad, and moreover, the poet has also compared the life of a tiger in confinement and as well as in forest or jungle when he is free to move anywhere. Okay, so line-wise description I'm also taking. He stalks in his vivid stripes. He stalks means he follows the path of the cage, or he covers the path of the cage in his vivid stripes. Vivid stripes means he is clear. Okay, clear stripes, he is moving. Okay, stalks and stripe. This is an example of consonants. Okay. And the few steps of the cage, of his cage, as the tiger was very, you can say, has very limited space to move. It is moving only in that limited space of the cage. On pads of velvet, quiet. Pads of velvet is an example of which poetic device? Yes. It is an example of metaphor. And he is moving on the pads of velvet. On the pads of velvet means, or he is moving on his soft paws. And it also means that one cannot hear the steps of the tiger in his quiet rage. Rage means anger. Okay. So quiet rage. Can you tell me which literary device used here is? Oxymoron. Why it is oxymoron? Very good. Okay. So see here. Quiet rage. Rage means anger. And quiet means silent. So, can this anger be ever silent? No. So, it means the adjective which is used here is opposite in meaning to that of the feeling that is used here. So, this is an example of oxymoron. So, this first paragraph, it depicts or it clearly explains the condition of the tiger when he is in the cage. Samarth, stand up from there. Second is. Next. He should be lurking in shadow. Lurking in shadow means he was hidden in order to. He was hidden in order to wait for his prey. Okay. So he was waiting for his prey to come so that he can make an attack at the tiger. So which literary device is used here in lurking in shadow? Lurking in shadow, which literary device or poetic device is used here? Imagery, yes. Lurking in shadow. Poem mein hai, I'm asking here, lurking in shadow, here alliteration is there. 1 minute, one, if someone will ask you just in this line, tell me the literary device, what would you say? I'm asking only in this line. So there is use of imagery. Personification, the entire poem is personified. Tiger is personified. Okay. So lurking in shadow, sliding through the grass, sliding through long grass, it is moving among the long reeds of the grass. And near the water hole where plump deer pass, and where he is waiting near a stream of water where he is waiting for his victim to come, or for a plump deer to come so that he can make an attack there, right? Next, so it means that the second paragraph, it explains the condition of the tiger when he is free, how he behaves in his natural habitat. Next, he should be snarling around houses. Okay, what is example of which poetic device is used here in snarling? Snarling is an example of what? It is an example of onomatopoeia. Right, because this sound, it is exactly identifying with the sound, warning sound produced that are produced by the animals. Actually, snarling means the warning sounds that are being produced by the animals. He should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge. At the jungle's edge means at the outskirts of the jungle or at the boundary of the jungle. Baring his white fangs. Baring means showing his white teeth, which are very sharp, his claws, and terrorizing the village. It means that he is moving there in order to terrorize the people there. So, but he is locked in a concrete cell. But now in the zoo, where he is locked in a cage, so what it is written, he is logged. He is used for tiger. So this is which literary device? Personification is used here. His strength behind bars. So his strength. Here S and S refers to which poetic device? Consonants. It is consonants. Okay. So his Raghav, I think you are talking. So, now he is locked in a concrete wall. His strength behind bars. It means that his complete strength is behind the bars. He is in confinement. His freedom is curtailed. And he is not able to use his strength. And he is helpless there. Okay? It means that tiger behind the bar or his ferociousness is no longer applicable. Stalking the length of his cage, ignoring visitors. Stalking means he's covering the length of the cage and ignoring the oncoming visitors. Okay. So he hears the last voice at night, the patrolling car. So at night, what he is listening, only the cars which are coming again and again to make inspection. He's just listening and stares with his brilliant eyes. So here with his brilliant eyes, with his brilliant hair, predominance of vowel sound I. So this is an example of assonance. What is this? Is an example of assonance. This is an example of assonance. At the brilliant stars, and the tiger is also looking at the brilliant stars with eyes full of intention, and intentively he is looking towards the sky. So what it means, the poet wants to deliver us to that freedom is an essential virtue. And that is not only to be enjoyed by human beings, but it is equal and basic right of animals too. It means that the animals should also enjoy their freedom. Okay. And if I talk about theme, what is the theme of the poem? That is cruelty against animals. Okay. Don't be cruel. Or it is cruel to keep animals in the zoo. They will feel angry and they will also feel helpless there. What enjambment? Enjambment is used, see, first two lines of first para, second para again, first two lines, third para, same thing, and last also. He should be snarling around houses, again used here. Anaphora means a repetition of same word or phrases in the starting of each and every line. For example, in 9th class, you have studied the poem wind. Again, that line was starting with wind. Okay? Example? He hears, yes, alliteration. He hears. Okay? And one thing I want to tell you is sometimes when you speak two words, consecutive words, there is, you can say, accidentally, transformation in the use of the words. Okay. For example, seashell on the seashore. When you speak, there is twist of the tongue accidentally. This is called as spoomerism. This is not related to you, but it came to my mind, so I discuss with you. Huh? Okay, speak any tongue twister. You can? Suppose there is a seashell on the seashore. When you will speak in fast forward manner or sometimes while talking also while speaking in a general way, there is shifting or you can exchange of words, a letter of a word. This is called as spoonerism. And next afterwards, two stories about flying that we are going to revise. So now, two stories about flying. The first one is about seagull. Okay, so which bird is included here in the story? It is seagull. Okay, so where the seagull was, it is sitting at the edge of a ledge. And what was the problem of seagull? That he was afraid to fly. Why the seagull was afraid to fly? Because he thought that his wings would not support him. Although his younger brothers and sisters, okay, how many brothers and sisters he has? Two sisters, one brother. In the very first line of the chapter, it is mentioned. Minor sister. Two brothers. Oh, yes. Two brothers, one sister. Yes. This is by mistake written. Two brothers and one sister. Right. In the very first line of the chapter, it is mentioned. Two brothers and one sister. And they have already made their maiden flight. Maiden means the first flight. Okay. They have already made their flight because they were courageous in nature. And they have mustered up their courage to make their flight. But this young seagull was afraid to make its flight in the sky because he thought that his wings would not support him. Okay. And for that, his, you can say, parents as well as his, you can say, younger brothers and sisters also, they were also upbraiding him. Upbraiding means they were scolding him also. Okay. Scolding him and that he should leave that ledge. Okay. So finally, the family decided where to go. The family decided to go to onto the nearby plateau. Almost 24 hours has been passed. And this, you can say, young animal, he was just looking towards his father, who was, you can say, who was providing different skills to their children. How to catch which fish? Herring. Okay, and how to devour it, how to make a cackling sound, and how to produce different kinds of sound. He was just looking at it, at them, and with expectant eyes, he was just feeling that they would come and provide him a piece of food also. He was trying various ways in order to attract them. So what he was doing, he sometimes would stand on one of his leg only and was above and behaving like he was about to fall. And the next time he has dozed off by, you can say, sinking his head inside his neck also. His mother was distantly, she was noticing about his behavior, and she very well knew that he was afraid to fly and was, you can say, and was not able to make his flight. Okay, he was mad with anger. He was so hungered up that he could not pass even a minute. Only his mother was noticing it. So next, what happened? His mother, she has taken a piece of dogfish and she came flying over the ledge where this seagull was standing or sitting. And in order to provide him food, she came very much near to that of seagull. But in spite of throwing it directly to his mouth, what she has done? She has thrown it down into the sea. But the young seagull, as he was mad with hunger, he has not eaten anything for the past 24 hours. He was madly feeling to eat something. So what happened? He dived into the sea. So for diving, what happened? After that, suddenly what happened? His wings, they spread apart. He felt a strong gush of air, or strong gushing air touched his, you can say, neck. The feathers were moving, and ultimately his wings were cutting the air, and ultimately he started flying. At first, he was seized with terror also, but this terror did not last long. Okay, soon he started flying in the sky, and then ultimately what has happened, his first flight, it was celebrated by his father also, as well as his other brothers and sisters. His other brothers and sisters, they have also made a flight along him, and ultimately they were producing different kind of sounds, okay, like ga 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 and all that. And finally he was tired, but he was afraid of the expanse of the green water that extended in front of him, and he has to land onto the sea water. He thought that he would not be able to make his balance on the sea water, and for that he swooped onto the sea water and felt that he would definitely sink. But sir, what happened? That was the innate skill of the seagull, that he he swam onto that green water also and was able to make his first flight. Right? And who were there? His brothers and sisters, as well as father and mother, were also there. They were praising him. They were also passing good remarks, and they were celebrating, giving him a piece of dogfish. Right? Clear this chapter? The second one is the black aeroplane. So what the black aeroplane is all about? The black aeroplane is about the mysterious experience of the pilot who was making his flight. From where he is making his flight? From Paris back to London. He was excited and he was eager to go to London. Because why? He wanted to spend some time with his family. He was waiting for that eager time that would be spent in the company of his family members. And moreover, he was also longing for English breakfast, because in Paris he was not able to get breakfast or food according to his wish. Okay, so which plane he was traveling in? The Kota DS-088. Okay, he was traveling. He has made a call to the control room of Paris, and when the other person on the signal side made everything clear, then what happened? He has made his plane to move on the runway and taken his flight. Okay, then he checked his tank fuels and he checked that there is enough fuel to reach to London. But suddenly what happened, before he go, when he has checked that Paris was left behind 150 kilometers, then what he has noticed? He has noticed that in front of him, storm clouds had gathered. Okay, suddenly the storm clouds had gathered, and ultimately what has happened? He was unable to check all the signals. When he was not able to check all the signals, and he has checked the fuel tank also, he had no option to go back to Paris, because there is not enough fuel left in the fuel tank that he would go back to Paris and would come back again. Right? So he had no other option except to venture into the storm clouds. He followed his flight and taken the risk of moving forward. But as he was engulfed in those storm clouds, the situation, it turned to be more sincere as well as difficult for him. Okay, how the situation has turned out to be more difficult and sincere? All the signals, they stopped working. Even the compass was not working. It became dead. It was moving round and round and was not showing any signal. He was unable to identify his direction. He was unable to comprehend his present position also. And he also did not know where to head his plane to. But suddenly, a miraculous experience, what he has faced was, that he has noticed the presence of an aeroplane without any lights, which came running parallel or which came flying parallel to his aeroplane. He could not identify, because the windows were closed, that who the pilot was or who was the pilot who was inside it, but he has noticed the gesture made by the pilot. He with his hand made a gesture to follow him like an obedient child. He had no other option except to follow him. And then what happened? He had followed that pilot. And soon what happened? He was out of that storm clouds. And that was really a miracle that happened in front of him. Later on, as a matter of gratitude, he thought to thank that pilot who has helped me in this kind of situation and who has helped me to come out of those storm clouds. And then what happened? When he has gone to the reception and asked the women at the reception, she has informed him that there was no other aeroplane being caught or being, you can say, noticed in the radar. It was only his aeroplane that was noticed, and he was all alone flying in the sky. And finally, that was still a mystery for him, that whether the aeroplane was there, or you can say, and who was the pilot who has saved his life, right? So let me ask you now, in between from the chapter now, some questions. Yes. Name, please. Palak. Okay, Palak, tell me, how did the young seagull's parents made him fly? They were upbraiding him, they were scolding him, okay? Then what happened? They went to the another plateau, okay? He was maddened with hunger, and it was only the one courageous act of a mother that made him fly. Stumpies. How does the author describe, how you can explain the young seagull's fear of flying? How can you explain the fear of flying of young seagull? Yes, Akhilesh, stand up. How can you explain the young seagull's fear of flying? If I want to ask you only in one line, how will you explain the fear of flying of young seagull? Sit down. He was afraid that his wings would not support him. Okay? He was quite afraid. This is the reason why he was not able to make any flight. Next, sit down, please. Question was, how does the author describe young seagull's fear of flying? He was so afraid that he could not make his flight, as he thought that his wings would not support him. So this was his fear of flying. Question is, while alone on ledge, how did seagull try to draw the attention of the family? Yes, Raghav, now you can tell. How the seagull tried to draw the attention of the family? Very good.
And drew a piece of fish, but instead of throwing it into his mouth, she threw it into the ocean. And guided by the smell of food and by mother, he thought of nothing except food and jumped right into the water.
Yes, to sink his head inside his neck. And yes, for the meritorious students group which has been formulated, I remember I was just thinking that I will post an assignment of comprehension too. Okay, because I feel this is also one of the weak part. Okay, because there sometimes you are in confusion, you people are always confused which option to be picked up. Okay, and for that, how many of you from meritorious and other students also, please let me know how many of you have solved sample paper one, which I have discussed सॉल्व किया था आप लोगों ने मेरे साथ. यू हैव बट यू हैवंट रेड द पैराग्राफ्स, है ना राघव? यू वर देयर एट दैट टाइम, सिमरप्रीत वाज आल्सो देयर ना. सो आई थिंक दैट एज अ फर्स्ट असाइनमेंट आई विल पोस्ट दोस सैंपल पेपर कॉम्प्रिहेंशन सीबीएसई वन. ओके, देन आफ्टरवर्ड सम अदर वंस ऑफ द डिफिकल्ट लेवल. ओके, एंड टू द क्लास ऑल्सो आई थिंक दैट आई विल पोस्ट कॉम्प्रिहेंशन इन द व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप. ओके, सो दैट यू कैन हैव एन एक्सेस टू इट, यू कैन रीड इट. आई विल फाइंड आउट अ वे हाउ टू स्कैन एंड गेट इट डन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ दैट रिटन पार्ट. रिटन ही भेजूंगी आपको, डोंट वरी. आई विल नॉट ट्राई टू सेंड अ क्लिक टू यू, राइट? सो दैट विल बी मच हेल्पफुल फॉर यू, एंड ट्राई टू सॉल्व इट. एंड ऑन द नेक्स्ट डे वी विल डिस्कस दैट कॉम्प्रिहेंशन टॉपिक इन द क्लास. हाँ हाँ, इट्स नॉट कंपल्सरी. नो नो नो, नॉट एट ऑल. I'm not concerned with only meritorious ones. If I will send in other groups, okay, meritorious one, the same comprehension for your reference, I can also send to others. You can also solve it. So that whenever I will discuss or I will send the key, you will have an access to it. Okay? So I don't want that learning should be limited one. Next one is, How did the seagull feel, or what were the feelings of the seagull when it dived over the fish? It means it is the time when his mother has dropped that piece of dogfish and he has made a dive into the sea. How the seagull feels? Yes, who will? Ekjot. How the seagull feels when he dives over the dogfish? Dives over dogfish. When his mother has thrown a piece of dogfish, he dived. How he feels? Or what kind of feelings overcame him? Not able to answer. I have explained clearly. Very bad. Okay. Nervous he was.
He was. He thinks he will be. He will not. He will die.
Yes. Afraid he was. Full of fear he. Okay. Then ultimately, yes, spread his wings. Soon the strong air was gushing. It was a mixture of feelings he was getting. Okay, right? And how did the family celebrate his first flight? Last girl, corner one. Your name, please. Ruhani? Okay, Ruhani. Let her answer first of all. How did the family celebrate his first flight? Right. They have made a flight around him, producing the various sounds like ga 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 and all that. And ultimately, when he landed onto the green sea, they also made a flight along with him and providing him energy that he would be balanced on that green water also. Right? Right. Sit down, please. So after that, the next one is how to tell wild animals to hai nahi hai na aapki. Okay. Next, afterwards, we are having ball poem. Theek hai, ball poem you have to do. I told you that incident na in paper. Ballroom, there one child was confusing the ballroom dance of that necklace. And ball poem. Bacha kahi jaye, ma'am, this question is wrong. I was saying why it is wrong. He says, ma'am, question was how did Matilda fell up? Matilda felt after the ball, or what changes has been brought about? Okay, in her life after the ball. Okay, the child was saying, ma'am, ye question hi wrong hai. Aapke necklace wala nahi hai. It was last year then. Okay, last year. Okay, that was pre-board. Okay, see, it means when you will read that chapter, na Matilda one, you must have heard that story, the necklace, that very beautiful girl, she was married to a clerk, And then what happened? She has borrowed a necklace from her friend in order to attend a party. The necklace was lost. Okay. And finally, they have taken, you can say, money from the moneylenders in order to pay the debt. And finally, they bought the same necklace of diamonds. But at the end, they came to know the necklace was not original. It was a false one. But that changed her life completely. From a beautiful lady, she has came up to her worn out looks, not properly dressed up and all, right? So that's all.